Today on Making It Home, I'm going to show you how I replace the handle on this Boy Scout hatchet as a gift for my son, who's an Eagle Scout, and I'm going to be using wood from three generations of my family's farms, including my great-grandfather's. Make sure you stick around and see how it turns out. Well, this is an exciting project for me because I'm going to take walnut wood from three generations of my family's farms, and I'm going to put this together with some Osage orange or hedge from my father's farm, and I'm going to make a new handle for this Boy Scout hatchet. I start by laying out all the pieces of wood that I had available and determining where I want to take the sections of wood out for the hatchet handle. This is a great place to take your time and make sure you get the sections of wood that you really want to use. Once I had all the pieces laid out, it was time to cut everything to size and get things glued together. The Osage orange had some crazy grain pattern, and that's going to come into play later in the handle. Because the handle is made up of five layers of wood, all the layers are actually fairly thin. I made the layers of Osage orange thinner than the walnut pieces just so the walnut stood out a little more. With all the layers of wood cut close to the right thickness, I finished sanding them down to the proper thickness on the drum sander. Okay, I've got all the pieces of the hatchet handle ready to go. I've got three pieces of walnut from three different generations, and then I've got a piece of Osage orange, a thin piece in between each layer of walnut. So I've got my great-grandfather, my grandfather, and my father's farms, all represented with pieces of walnut. So I'm gonna glue these together next and give these a few days to set up, and then I'm going to carve the handle. Check out the end grain there. That looks really cool. I always think it looks funny because the grain pattern is going in different directions. It looks wider here on that center ply of walnut than it does over here. But in actuality, it is straight. It is parallel. It is a nice uniform layer. But when you look at it like that, to me, it looks like the center layer is wider on the left than it is on the right. Anyway, I think that's looking great. I think this is gonna be an awesome handle for this Boy Scout hatchet. So next I'm going to start cutting it in shape. I just cut a little outside of the shape of the handle that I had drawn on the wood blank. I started out shaping the handle with a draw knife, but I quickly realized that with the wood being so dry and brittle, that I had to switch over to something called a Shinto rasp. This tool works amazingly well at removing material and shaping the handle. As you can see, I slowly crept up on the size of the hatchet handle so that the head would fit nice and snug. Yeah, I think that'll do. Nicely lined up.
Next, I added a slight taper to the handle by running it through the bandsaw. I did this so the handle was a little thicker at the base. Before I fully remove the flat faces on the handle, I thought it would be best to run the hatchet handle through the bandsaw and create the slices for the wedges to hold the head on. Almost all of the shaping on this hatchet handle was done with that Shinto rasp I mentioned earlier. This thing is just fantastic for shaping something like this that's free-flowing. This actually has a coarse side and a fine side, so you can really be aggressive with material removal if you want to. I worked my way down the hatchet handle from the head down to the base, doing all of the shaping. I wanted the bottom of the hatchet handle to have some fairly flat faces, and so I waited until the rest of the handle was shaped to cut these off on the bandsaw. So next it was time for everybody's favorite part, the sanding. The rasp I used left a fairly smooth finish, so this really didn't take too long. A couple of the last pieces of wood I had to cut were the wedges for the head of the hatchet. This was cut from a piece of spalted maple from the tree I used to play in growing up. After a quick dry fit of all the wedges, it was time to glue the head in place. I started out by adding the larger wedge, which is the widest piece that goes from front to back on the hatchet head. Then I added the two small pieces on the sides, which created the cross pattern. So I got lucky. I was trying to tap the head on a little tighter, get it down farther on the handle because it had popped up a little bit, and I actually broke the wedge off. But luckily enough, it broke off above the hatchet head. So I think I'm still good. We'll see how this thing looks tomorrow once I cut the excess off. Not too bad. Got a little spalting right in the middle. It's pretty uniform. You got the Odie's oil. Right, so this stuff always makes everything look fantastic. Cross pattern, that's looking good. Got that end grain. Nice and dark on the walnut. That Osage orange has that cross pattern or that chevron pattern. Check that out. That walnut is looking great. Thanks for sticking around and watching the video today.
This was probably one of my most challenging builds I've done so far. I've never done a hatchet before, so I'm really happy with how this turned out. Make sure you subscribe so you can follow along with some of the upcoming videos we have, and you can also check out some of the older videos with wood, electronics, and metal projects. Thanks for watching.